Lead the Way, a podcast for school leaders with author, speaker, and educator, Dr. Bill Ziegler.
Welcome to Lead the Way, a podcast for principals by principals in 5 minutes or less. I am super excited for today's special guest, Dr. Quentin Lee of Childersburg High School in Alabama. Quentin, it's so great to have you on the program today.
Hey, Bill, thank you for having me. It's just been an honor just to be in your presence today, and I'm so excited.
Dr. Lee, you're doing a lot right now around COVID-19 and supporting your students and families during this time. Why don't you share with our listeners what you're doing?
Well, the vision for our district is simple. It's customer service and communication. So that's the forefront of what we're doing. We want to make sure that we're providing these services to our students and to their families. And at the same time, letting our community know that even though COVID-19 has definitely hit our community hard, we're still going to make sure that we put our students first. So one thing that we're doing is we're carrying on with our lessons virtually. Our teachers are conducting Zoom calls, Google Hangouts, and Google Meets, Google Classroom. So they're still continuing with their instruction. And for those who don't have internet, we've actually prepared paper packets that we deliver to them. We also have been providing food. Twice a week, they can come to school to receive a breakfast and lunch that they can take home and eat in the convenience of their home. So we're doing everything we can to make sure that we provide these services to our students and to their families to let them know that we definitely care.
Dr. Lee, I love that where you talk about communication and customer service. And what a powerful reminder as principals that we need to go to the next level and even take things to kids' homes. Tell us about a time that you visited a kid's home to drop something off.
Well, actually, we had 17 students that didn't have internet. So me and my assistant principal, we just loaded up in the driver's ed car. And we drove around for about 4 hours delivering packets. And we got to see where our kids live, got to have conversations with them face to face, see them in their element versus being inside the walls of the school. And I think that's really important for principals. If we really want to make an impact, we've got to get outside of the walls of our building to see where these kids come from and see what they're dealing with on a day-to-day basis. And it's not just a one-time thing. It has to be something that you're passionate about all the time so that those kids know that those relationships are genuine, that they're true.
That is so powerful. So tell us, like, you know, the customer service and the communication, how has your families responded to that?
Extremely well. When all this broke out, I did a Zoom conference for my senior parents. I had about 50-something parents on the line. I do this thing called Kicking It with Dr. Lee, which is twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays, where I just get on and I do a character education lesson for my students. I play some quizzes games with the students. I give away prizes. Just talk to them. I've started having special guests that appear on the Kicking It with Dr. Lee. And it's about a 25-minute session with my students. I get to see their faces. We get to laugh, have a lot of fun. We've also done grade level meetings where we get to talk to our students, get their input. And we do it for the parents too. So it's the main thing is that even though we're not physically together, we still can be virtually together. And that's the main thing, making sure they know that we're still together and we're there for each other.
Yeah, those powerful connections really resonate with kids during this time. They need to see us as more than just educators, but as people that care about them. Wouldn't you agree with that?
I would definitely agree with that. And I think that's the motivating factor. A lot of these students, I mean, with their home lives, they don't have to do this schoolwork. And I think some of them realize like, well, it doesn't really matter. But because of the relationships that have been formed with the principals and with the school staff and their teachers, they know I want to do this because I don't want to disappoint them. And I think that's the key part. Like, we've got to hone in right there. So when we do get to regain our physical being able to be with each other, we don't have to fight those battles because the relationships are so solid.
You know, when you talk about the importance of relationships, it's so powerful. And just, it reminds me of educators that have invested in my life as a kid and now educators that I see investing in the lives of so many students. You know, as we close out here, Dr. Lee, what's one word of advice you would give principals right now on leading their schools during COVID-19?
I think the number one thing that we need to do as principals in during this COVID-19 is we need to listen. We need to listen to our teachers, listen to our parents, listen to our students, because everyone is dealing with this in a different way. And we can't assume that the cookie cutter approach is going to solve everyone's problems. So we've got to listen and we've got to respond to what we hear.
That is outstanding. Dr. Lee, thank you so much for being on Lead the Way today.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
And listeners, I'd encourage you to check out my latest book, You Don't Need Superpowers to Be a Kid's Hero. Again, thank you so much, Dr. Lee, for being on the program. An outstanding message to principals.
Thank you for having me, sir.
You've been listening to Dr. Bill Ziegler with Lead the Way. Bill has great resources for school leaders at chaselearning.org. That's chaselearning.org. Thanks for listening to Lead the Way with Dr. Bill Ziegler.